Alright, final take.
Oh, oh, what have you done? Lock me up, I've fallen in love. Get me out of here, I said get me out of here. And I have homework and shit I need to do. Late assignments and papers overdue. I'm all out of tears.
With October in full swing, our carnivorous plants are starting to flower at Carnivorous Plant Sydney. This Sarracenia Lacophila has such beautiful red flowers. Sarracenia flowers are such an interesting thing. They have a female and a male part in the same flower, unlike Nepenthes, which have one plant is either a male or a female, and you need one of each to make seeds with the flowers. Alright, so I'm going to be using just a paintbrush for pollination. You can use a cotton swab, or this paintbrush isn't very good, but I'm just going to be cross-pollinating some Sarracenia Lacophila flowers. So this is what the Sarracenia flowers look like when they're just starting to pop open. Pretty small, just like a little small round bulb. I think in my last video I showed some small little bulbs popping out. Well, that one that I was showing before, it looked like how it did in my video. Now it looks like that. So yeah. For these, I've got better paintbrush and some scissors. These flowers are quite small for this time. I mean, it's somewhere like mid-October when I'm recording this, and it's raining a lot, and it's not really spring weather. And these having Sarracenia's having flower stalks takes a lot of their energy. As you can see, they haven't really started picturing yet, and I just don't think that these plants are big enough, and I don't really especially want flowers of this type. These plants I'm looking into selling on the website, so I'm just going to go ahead and cut off the flower spikes. It's hard for a lot of people, but it's better off with a plant if they're this small. Trying not to damage the pitches or the rhizome. I'm using scissors because I can't find any pruning shears, so it's a bit harder. I recommend you use sterilized pruning shears for this process, but I just don't have them on me right now. These being cut off. Alright, so now these plants are fine. We're going to move into pollinating the big guys. I'm trying to film this and do it without putting my arm in the shot, so this is a hard angle to do it at. But if you look inside, the Sarracenia flower has a male part and a female part. So if we go down, there's lots of ants in here. If we open up here, Sarracenia, they're supposed to be pollinated by bees, but it's much more certain if you just pollinate them yourself, because it's hard for bees to get in, because often they just sit up here, and what they need to do is actually go in through here or under here, which is pretty hard for a little bee to do. So if you turns out I'm not in the shot, great. I keep doing that. If you look inside, you can see all these little yellow things. Those are all holding the nectar. The nectar's fallen off, and that is all the nectar. So I'm going to be very carefully picking up the paintbrush from the floor without spilling this and without stopping the camera. I'm going to just dab a little to the end of my paintbrush. You can see it's got some pollen on it. I'm going to put that back. Boom. Then I'm going to take this one over from here and I'm going to pull up this little segment that's down here. I'll just try to get these out of the way. Alright, so these, and I'm going to rub the pollen with the paintbrush over these little stigmas. And I'm going to make sure each one gets some pollen. I think there's five in this plant. Alright, so now I've got pollen on this one. I'm going to go back to this flower. I'm going to rub it on these. You can repeat the process a few times if you want to. I have done this process a few times with this flower before recording, so I will not be showing that in the video, but if you want a better chance of getting a good result, then I'd advise doing it more times. Whoops, that was not a good way to put the flower down. Okay, we've got one more. Got two types, two different pollens on here. I'm gonna, this is, I think, the youngest flower here. So I'm gonna be opening that up. Nice pollen inside. Take the pollen, go into the stigma, stamen. There we go. Alright, that is how to pollinate Sarracenia. Oh, okay, there's just pollen going everywhere. Let me go a few more times just to make sure, because I really want flowers of this type. This is such a great Lycophila. It's got really tall traps, and I'm really looking forward to having more of them, because you can never have too many Sarracenia Lycophilas. So I'm gonna put that on a t-shirt. Do we have a merch store? No, we don't have a merch store. Jet, if we make a merch store, yeah, make sure you put a t-shirt with a quote saying, what was it? Oh yeah, you can never have too many Sarracenia Lycophilas. All right, cool. There we go. Those are done, I'm gonna let those sit. Now I've got a bit of this Lycophila, and there's this really nice Sarracenia over here that has really vibrant red traps. So I'm thinking, might be doing some cross-pollination here. All right, I'm gonna take this Lycophila flower. I forgot about this one, haven't opened it yet. There's all the nectar in here that, I'll take all that. Ants have been making their homes in here. Not there. I'm gonna take this couple down, this flava down here. What is this? This is a flava alata, some sort of hybrid already. It has really nice red traps. I'm gonna put that here on this diamond. I think I waited a little too long with this one because there's not any pollen left, but hopefully this. So, yep. That's all good. Sarracenia. So, hopefully, I'll know with this and this. I might put a little marker on these two because I know I've mixed these pollinations. So, I might get flava. I'm going to check what hybrid this is because I've forgotten, but it's got really nice red traps. I know it has flava and alata. Cool. So, yep. That's pretty much all you got to do. Yeah. This is Josh buzzing off, I guess.
Lock me up, I'm falling in love. Get me out of here. I said get me out of here. And I have homework and shit I need to